discovered that the problem we have, especially in this our side, is that we don't have the right mentorship. The ideology of seeing somebody who has made it or who is doing well, and you ask him, how far, how did you do it? He says, it's God. All of us, we are all serving God. There is always secret to success. When you know that secret, you become a winch to success. Because what you don't know is bigger than you. So that is why I titled it Billionaire's Master Keys. Because in this part, in the Western world, I've traveled around the world, and I discover when a white man discovers something, they write a book. Their next generation, they will start reading it, and they will take it off from there. They will improve on what their forefathers have done. But our own, when we discover anything, we will not tell anybody. When you die, that is the end. That is the problem and the backwardness of Africa. Because you all know, during our own pain, there is how you'll be playing, there will be an injury you will have. They will pluck what you call a willow, they will put it. That is the end of that system. But those people that knows all those things are all gone. They did not put it in the book. They did not transfer the knowledge to anybody. That is how even our culture and everything is dying. And I have said in my own time, I will change that modality. I have, yes, I'm not from a rich home. I'm from a very poor and wretched home. But today, the problem I faced when I was a little boy, my children are not facing it. That is transformation, rocket transformation. So I must tell everyone how I did it. Hello? So I want to first ask the question, how many of us here have been babbling for 10 years, which is one decade? Don't be shy. Don't be shy. Do you understand? We have come to rub mind as brothers. Then, how many of us here, you cannot bring down your hand. How many of us here that have raised their hand are also babas, and babbing is your only business? Raise your hand. Okay, nobody. That means we are trying. Are you there? Example. Vision is as you are sitting down, you are seeing, you are planning, you are strategizing. What am I going to become in 10 years' time? What am I going to become in 5 years' time? Where am I going to be in 20 years' time? That is a vision. A man without a vision is a blind man. Now, that is where I come into your business. There is nobody that say because you are a papa, you are going to end up a papa. No. Babbling is a stepping stone to where you are going to. And I'm going to give you a very rugged example. All of us, we know Chacho. Chacho was a papa. He might also still be papping. But in our present year, Chacho transformed from being a papa, he went into DJ. From being into DJ, he went into selling of phone when phone started coming out. From phone, I tell you now, forget even we that are into real estate. That guy has bought the whole world. After you go say, which job will you? Which job will you? Are you there? So, what is your vision for tomorrow? That you are babbling, the first question you ask yourself, this babbling, if this is my business and this is what I'm doing, where is this business going to take me in 10 years' time? And I tell you, as a baba, if they leave the world born with you, you are the only baba. The possibility of you building 4 flats is very slim. The possibility of you driving a Range Rover is very slim. So, if you want to build 4 flats tomorrow, in the next 10 years, if you want to drive a Range Rover, because your mates are driving it, The people who are graduating, do they have 2 heads?
No.
The people who are building mansion, do they have 2 heads?
No.
So if you are putting yourself in a position that I want to enjoy all these things in future, what next will I do? That will now give you targets. If had it been, thank God your chairman is waking up now. If he had not been, they are doing POS in that same shop. Is it not the same amount he was paying before? They are doing, he's doing real estate. And they get him, if I go back, they make call, make him find house for somebody. Is it not the same office? So that barber salon can produce more than 5-6 offices for you. Without even, with the cost of only rent and that generator you are doing, your barber will still be going on. Are you there? So, you need to be creative because we are made in the image of God. And in Genesis chapter 1, it said the world was without form and God created. For God to have created, he made you in his own image. You have been brought to create, you must be creative. You have to think, you must be creative. And you must learn